I'm Sai, and welcome back to my channel. Sai, to your interest, will try to do the RAM management and the multitasking test in the IQ 7 device after filling the storage up to 99%. So yes friends, I did fill the storage up to 99%, and right now I'm gonna do a RAM management check by opening these 30 applications. So not 20, not 25, but 30 applications. Let's see friends whether the 30 applications will be remaining in the background memory or not. That is what I'm going to try to push its limits. And all these applications are, I did not include any kind of games. These are the normal applications only. So let's see friends whether this phone can actually capable of doing that one or not. First, let's show you the exact model. So I'm trying to use the IQ 7 and I'm trying to use the extended RAM capabilities. So 8+ 3GB of RAM as well. And it is the RAM and storage details as you can see right now. So out of 128GB, 127GB I did full, and out of 11GB of RAM, 2.88GB is currently used, and remaining everything is available. So let's see friends how is the RAM management in this phone. And I did install close to 165+ applications in this phone at this moment, and I'm going to do a separate video on that particular topic as well, installing close to 300 and 400 applications. So make sure to stay tuned for that video. That will be really epic one. So let's see friends, let's get started with this kind of 30 applications which I'll try to open and close it, and I'll try to see in the multitasking whether those will be present or not. That is what my main motive of doing this kind of test. Right now, as you can see friends, there is nothing in the background running. You can clearly see that. So let me try to open the one by one application. I'll try to keep something in the memory in the background just to see. So this is the DRMF info which I'm trying to open, and this is the music player application. As you can see friends, everything is opening pretty faster, very smooth, no issues, no lag, nothing. So I'll try to compare this kind of test with other smartphone as well, opening this 30 applications with any other smartphone is possible or not. And today I'm going to receive the IQ3 device, so make sure to stay tuned for that video. And it's a Google Chrome and WhatsApp. I'm trying to type some member and keeping in the background as a memory, and even the Instagram as well, I'm trying to keep some memory in the background, and Flipkart. I'm trying to open some of the one mobile phone and I'm keeping in the memory as a background. This is what I'm trying to do with friends every time I do this kind of review. And Amazon, let's keep the memory in the mobiles. So it's the mobiles, and let me try to keep this in the memory as a background. YouTube. So this is a video which I just uploaded yesterday doing the speed test comparison. Make sure to check that video. I'll try to keep this also in the background as well. Now let's move to the next, is a speed test. So this is a really intense kind of testing friends. I did not try this kind of 30 applications ever. Yes, I did not try the 30 applications. So this is my first time doing this kind of testing on this IQ 7 device in terms of testing the 30 apps opening in this IQ 7 device. This is going to be really epic one. So let's say I'm trying to keep this as a memory in the background, the speed test results as well. That's another thing which I thought of showing you. So let's keep in the background this memory. Let's see. So I'll try to go to the home page once after this finish. So make sure to comment below friends, what are your thoughts doing this kind of testings and unique kind of intense kind of pressure I'm trying to put only in the performance. I'm trying to do this kind of testings on this phone. I'm trying to keep this in the background. So next is the camera and Facebook, and next Prime Videos. Let's see Prime Videos, what will happen with the Prime Videos. And next Ghana, Myntra, Paytm. As you can see, I'm trying to open something and keep it in the background. And this is a Zoom application. Let's sign in and let me try to type something, and I'm trying to keep it in the background. Next calls. So calls also I'm trying to keep it like this, and next is messages. This is a normal message as you can see here. I'm trying to keep it in the background, and gallery. I'll try to keep open one of the image. Let's open this video and I'll try to keep in the background this video in the gallery, and the calendar. Calculator. And next is Amazon Music, Facebook Lite. As I said, I'm trying to use multiple testings friends, multiple times. So Messenger, Fast. So I'm trying to keep even this application in the background. So overall, I'm close to 30 applications opening in this IQ 7 device, and just checking the background RAM management, how efficient it can be there, keeping the 30 apps in the background. If 30 is working, then I'll be trying to use maybe 40 applications in the next upcoming video. So stay tuned for those videos. These kind of testings will be really interesting to push the limits. In case if you want me to do this kind of testing on other smartphones like MI11X or Realme X1 Max, so make sure to comment below friends. Definitely I can do those videos for you all. So this is in the background. So next is a Z5. So let's keep the Z5 in the background as well, and yes, done. So now let me show you the multitasking tray, and there are 30 applications has been opened from the first clock to last. As you can see, 30 applications, friends, it's going to be really insane. Let me see whether the clock will be showing exact time or not when I'm selecting. That will be the really thing when this kind of exciting for me as well. 1, 2, 3. Yes, it's exact, friends, exactly. It did not even get reload a little also did not get reloaded in this IQ7 device. I'll try to do the same kind of testing, the Realme X1 Max and MR NX as well, definitely. Not only on this phone. In case, depending on the comments, I'll try to do, friends. If I get the comments, I'll do. And this is the DRMF info. Exact position. Perfect. Not a little bit got reloaded. Not bad. And music, same. YouTube music as well. Nothing got reloaded. Same, as you can see, friends. Exactly. I'll try to open from here. It should be kind of okay. It will be kind of really faster way to do it every time going to the multitasking. Just for you, as a proof to show you that all the applications are in the open in the background. That is the reason every time I'm trying to show you exactly. As you can see, friends, as a proof, all the applications are completely open in the background. Now let's move to the next is Flipkart. Same phone. What I selected before, it's open. Amazon Prime also no problem. YouTube perfectly done. Speed test also exactly same results. It did not get refreshed. Excellent. And even the Play Store, even the camera as well. Facebook also same thing, whatever I typed. Prime also nothing got changed. Ghana perfect. Myntra, yes. Paytm as well, exact same page. As you can see, friends, now I'll try to show you what is the RAM management, how much it utilized. Before it is 2.88 GB used. Now let's see how much kind of RAM is used after opening 30 applications. That is what I'm going to show you as well. In the album, same video I have opened. Calendar, calculator, same thing. Music, Amazon Music, same. Facebook Lite, Messenger Lite, and the fast, same speeds which are like before even now. And this other G5, as you can see, friends, overall in this kind of 30 applications testing the RAM management, it did work out well. I did know that these are very small and basic applications only. I just want to push the limits, friends, and maybe tomorrow I'll try to come up with the 50 applications opening in the background. So make sure to stay tuned for that video in case if you're interested. So let me just show you exactly how much RAM is used right now. Let me just go to the RAM. 3.78 GB is used. So before it is 2.88 GB is used, now 3.78 GB. Wow, only 1 GB got used after opening 30 applications in the background. That's like insane, friends. That's really great, I would say. So for the normal everyday day-to-day task, you should not have any kind of issues in this IQ7 device. Definitely, you did see the live proof what has happened right now in front of the camera only. You did see that it did not get any kind of lag or delay while opening any kind of applications. That's perfectly good. So thank you for watching this video, friends, and for more interesting this kind of videos and unique ideas, so make sure to hit the subscribe and like this video, and see you in the next video. Until then, stay tuned for more updates. Until then, bye.